Samuel, I don't know where you get your big heart for the youth from, but I've seen your ghetto film project.
Yeah, yeah.
Slightly enlighten us about it before we wind up.
Yeah, the ghetto film project is being led, or it's an initiative by a filmmaker called George Stanley Samba. I'm a pioneer in there.
Wow.
It's more like an initiative or an organization where we mentor and share film knowledge to the kids in the ghetto who can't go to a film school to learn film.
Yeah.
So we bring film to them. It's usually a free service to every kid in the ghetto. They learn how to make movies, they learn how to act, they learn how to write, and they become great filmmakers. I learned some things from there because I was there in 2014. I learned more skills. Then I came out, I became a filmmaker who is establishing the industry, and I go back and teach the others.
Wow, sounds like you're doing a lot for the young people out there and the movie industry in Uganda.
Right.
Samuel is definitely someone I looked for myself because I'm interested in acting. So before we leave, I have a challenge for Samuel and his gang. He moved with his kids that he met us. Are they kids?
They're not kids.
Let's use a softer term.
Yeah, with my people, my friends.
Yeah, so they're young people just like me. I love acting. We're going to take on a challenge acting. We're going to think through a skit. Then we'll have to act. If you've not seen me act, if you think I'm not going to Hollywood, watch this, guys. For now, Samuel, share your handles, how they can reach out to you and all that, and then we'll get into the skit.
Now, those who want to reach out to me, go and Google my name, Zito Samuel Sevier. Sevier has a U in it. When you Google that name, you will see more of my Facebook, Twitter, and everything. And you inbox me, I will talk more.
Thank you. That is all we have for you. For now, catch us in the skit. Me acting, Samuel is the director, and the young people like me, you know, having fun in this whole role. Keep it locked.
Do you think she's coming?
Yeah, she's coming.
But why do you like her? Even my ex is better than her.
Your girlfriend disgusts me, your girl.
I don't really like her. I just
really?
Like her money.
She's like an old man. She
no, she's actually coming to pay our bills to the
office.
Yeah.
Let's
I don't really like.
What do we have here? How are you guys doing?
How are you, baby?
We are fine.
Ah, you're fine. I see. Hmm? Gossiping.
What?
You think I didn't hear you guys?
No.
What is she
We're
talking
just
about?
Praising you. You're praising me.
She looks like her grandma. How dare you?
Oh, you're cute.
As in, guys, I've taken you out on my bills.
What?
I've paid for your tuition before. And you? The shoes you're wearing. Your BD last year, I gave them to you. So how dare you speak
We weren't
about
talking
me?
About you, babe. We
what
were.
What kind of friends are you?
No.
And you think I'm going to still pay your bills? Oh, please. Guys, I've heard it. Don't even call me.
Girl, we're not cool.
Oh my goodness, woo! Guys, I had a lovely time. My goodness, if you thought I wouldn't act, I've definitely proved you wrong. So definitely, I hope you've enjoyed this. If you're watching and you want to be part of Platform 256, a young person with an initiative, if you're a role model, you can always be part of this. All you have to do is reach out to us on our Facebook page. That is Platform 256. If you want to feature on my show, I'm always welcoming people in and out, you know, day in, day out. Keep the love coming in. For now, Zoe Inspiration, I'm signing out.
Well, welcome back anyways, guys. We are heading into the Youth Talk segment where, by the way, I sat down with some of Hannah's students basically to get to know, you know, it has been a continuous topic that has been trending in news for some time. That is the teacher's strike. If you're not in the know, let me get you up to speed. So the teacher's strike started. They gave government an ultimatum since February to either step up on those salaries or they are stepping down. And of course, it happened after there was no response, basically no response. Now the increment is about 502 billion Ugandan shillings. That's the increment they want. But discussions have failed and they agreed at least 50%. Now, I sat down with the students and finally we had to talk about this. What can be done? Because this is something that has happened for a long time. It has been in the news for, I think, years now. And it was finally time to talk about it. What can be done? How can we end the teacher strike? How can it be helped? And let's check out the Youth Talk segment with Hannah International. When we come back, we have so much more. Keep it locked. Welcome back, guys. I told you guys that I'm getting all the cool kids, the cool squad of Hannah International. Now, when I say cool squad, I mean it. You look at the ladies here. Yeah, I always start with the ladies because we are the pretty squad here. But of course, I also have some cool guys, and we're going to talk about all the different topics that I told you about. And if you want to get in touch and also let us know your opinion, everything has to be done on social media. Keep it online. So at Pfizer Fabs on Twitter, at Urban TV, Facebook, Platform 256. Let us know what you think on all the different topics. So guys, like we have some different things that have been happening, a current trend. Now, if you guys have been watching, I don't know if this affects your school as well, but our teachers have been striking, and they put down, they gave government an ultimatum in February to either work on their demands, which have been in place for so long, or they put down their tools, and they recently did. But government responded that they have other priorities at the moment, which are more serious to attend to. And those guys can wait, and I've been telling them to wait, but teachers are so tired. Okay, so I want to know if this also affects you, if it affects your school, if it affects even your teachers. Are they also in the same boat?
Okay, good evening, everyone. Hello, I'm called Mugabe Derek. I'm in Form 6. This issue of teachers striking, it affects even this school because we have two sections. We have the UNEB section and the Cambridge section. So when it comes to the UNEB section, they are also kind of, sort of affected because now they have friends who still work in the same area. And the Cambridge section, for them, they are a bit not almost all that affected because the teachers who teach there, they can still come and do the same in UNEB.
Dr. Daniel Malcolm at Hanna International School. I think what can help those teachers, the government should quickly respond to them because...
But they've told them the other priority. What do you mean to have your money? They should. They need to work on at the moment.
Okay, as in quickly responding to them.
Mm. Yeah. How?
About the payment.
And they should increase that payment?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because they really do a good work.
Okay, pass the mic.
Hey, I'm Mutesi Patience, Hanna International School. I think the government should quickly respond to the teachers because they really need this money. And if teachers are not in those schools, like... Okay, what I know, most of the teachers quit their teaching, and most of the people can't afford like the expensive schools, so they have to go to these government schools, which really affects the students. If teachers don't come to attend to them, they really don't know what to do, and time has really gone. So the government should really respond to the teachers. They really need this. Thank you.
And what do you guys think, Manai? Should they also respond to them? Should they work? What basically should be done? Okay, you want them to respond, but how? With money? With words? What?
I'm Wendo Delton Maliro, Hanna International School. For the case of the teachers, I would like the government to really increase their salary. Simply because recently there was a debate about there was an issue of the members being paid for the OTT. And this really surprises me that a person who is training the nation is being denied salary or is being given less compared to those guys. They get heavy salaries. But when a teacher complains, you find that they delay saying that they have other priorities. Katiche nebuza, priority endala zebali na kukusasura otiti waba MPs afuna milioni ya satubuli mwezi, minus allowances. Please, they should put this in consideration. Because kati omusomesa ye okuga ambante ya gara nyomusara. He has trained people who are getting now getting heavy salaries, and now he's just requesting for an increment, and you're just saying that you have other priorities. Which other priorities are those if they are not teachers?
It's Nansley Joyce. I'm from Hanna International School. My opinion won't be all that different from the others, cause like teachers have really, really, really helped us. Like they have helped the whole nations, and those ones who are not also educated, you also see this, like you need it, because if you're not educated, your daughter is being educated, or anyone. Now they really need the money because they also have kids like how you do, and they really need this money to support themselves and everything like they can.
Everyone has that opinion that the money should be increased regardless of what. My brother here said it's the best way. The other priorities are not there. What priorities are you talking about? So it's about time we worked on these issues. And as aside from that, so if my opinion, so let me guys let you know. Recently I was in a team, team session, like a team building session with some people. And our supervisor let us know that sometimes it's not about growing upwards, but sideways. How do you grow sideways? So you diversify into what you're doing. If you're a teacher, you can diversify into, something else. Now, I was recently talking to one of your teachers who's an art teacher. But you can diversify and start doing, you paint Portraits are sold very expensively. You sell them, so it's about also diversifying. Don't just wait to kuyambe. No, we are, but she's again. Anyways, I also want to get to something fun because you know, Miss Tin is here. The ladies are always represented. No matter what, have you ever seen Hannah at the finale? Hey, those girls can bring fire. Otherwise, for now, keep it urban. We'll be right back. Welcome back, guys. We are still here on the Youth Talk segment. Now, Hannah was very, very interesting. One of the students had the most interesting answer. He said that, sincerely, if we're not paying, we're concentrating on other priorities. Is OTT paying OTT for ministers the biggest priority they have right now? But actually, at the moment, the reason why government put a priority was because they're concentrating on youth employment, they're concentrating on the oil sector, and so much more. But finally, they sat down with the president and had a one-on-one, and they're giving them until July to sort their issues. By July, if it fails, then they'll go back to the strike. So I have some top three movie trailers that are coming up. First of all is Coma, 47 Meters Down and Cage. 47 Meters is a suspense movie. Man, they are actually stuck below, like underwater, and there are sharks everywhere. You've seen these typical movies about sharks, but trust me, if I put this one on the list, it's because it is going to be fire. And another one is Coma. Coma is a horror story. And another one is Swamp Thing. Swamp Thing is coming out in May, but it's a series. So you need to watch out for this one because it's interesting. There's horror, there's suspense, there's thriller. There's so much that is happening in this movie. But for now, you guys are going to check out the top three trailers right here on the show. When you come back, we have a fashion thing for you guys.